Yeah, hello guys, welcome back to Humble FX. Today we are doing a live video on our challenge where we are doing someone chat me up and say that it will be better we start afresh from scratch so that people will follow up and see how I do it. So that's why I have started afresh with $5 today. So what we're doing is that we are taking just two candles in 8 trades per day. You will see this is $5 account right now, and I'm taking just 8 entries for today. Okay, so we're taking it together. Let's see how we can grow it. I enter because I missed the first entry, which is this point. Okay, now this is another entry here. It came down to level of 20, so I should take my two candles and exit the trade. Okay, you can see many entries that I have shown here. All right guys, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and turn on the bell so that you can get notified once we upload new video to the channel. Okay, in here we are doing a challenge of $5 to $1,000 in 12, or let me say in 2 weeks, and we pray that we'll achieve that goal. All right, so I will give you guys the trading plan I'm using for that, and let us see how we go about it. Okay, so I'll need the comments if you need the plan, if you want me to send the trading plan, comment on the comment box. I need you to do a video on the trading plan. Just comment on the video. I need you to create a video on the trading plan so that I will know that you guys need the trading plan. I missed this one too. All right, so comment on the video and we'll take it from there. This one I missed the entry, which is a sniper entry. Look at my analysis here and analyze it to buy from this point, and look at what happened from there. It shoot up. That is price action in action. Look at that was a levels here. So I know that this point is a point where it will test, and look at what happened. It came down there and we are going. My first TP should be at this little line if I enter the market. All right, this one has two profits. We have two profits the first trade. Let's see. This one has moved far above, so we don't want to take this trade because it is, even though it's a buy entry, it's a buy trade, but look at this. It can be effective. Sometimes it can be effective, so let us ignore it. After all, it has moved a long distance. Let's take another entry. Boom. 1,000. This one has not met our trading plan. Let's come back to price 500. At least we can take this one again. Like I told you earlier yesterday, that our first TP is at level of 50. So at this point, we can take another entry right now. That is our second entry. Remember, we are taking 8 trade. Now we are taking our second entry today. All right. I entered it because number one, this thing has not reached level 50. Number two, there is a small level that has been crossed at that point. There is a small level that I'm seeing here. Look at the level. This small spike here. Is a level, yes, it can affect you sometimes. So that's why I traded it, because it's across it, and this thing has is still coming to level 50, so I still have chance to take another entry at that point. So let me set my TP. So two candles to set your TP, just put in 2 digits after the entry price. Here's your entry price here. So you just put two digits to the number before the point, which is 8075. So that should be 8077 instead. Point the decimals. Yeah, modify. All right, we are moving. That is where we take our profit. First, take profit. Let me see if we can hold longer. No, this is a risky trade to hold longer. Let us just take our TP and go away. And that is our second entry for the day. All right, let's wait a bit. Yeah, this crash has also took profit. That's took profit. That is our second trade. I want to check if it is still good for us to enter it. Our first TP has hit level 50. Remember, our next TP is level 80. At this point, even though it's not good, it's not actually nice to enter it again, but because I want us to finish this easily, let me enter it again. It's the third time. That's the third entry for the day. We need just 8 entries for the day. We need 8 trades for the whole of today. And now we are taking the third entry. So which means when this one takes profit, we are now going for the fifth entry. Let's check if there's other ones that you see that I say it's not a good entry, and look at that, it's now spiked. At this point I should enter my trade, but I don't have enough equity to trade it. Look at this, I can enter my trade after this first candle has finished forming. I can still enter my trade from here to take my two candles and go away. All right, but I don't have enough equity to enter it again right now. Like right now I should take this trade, but right now I can't take it now. All right, let's check for crash 1000. Let's see if those levels have been taken off. Yes, this level has been taken off, so we can take this trade right now for two candles. But yet, as usual, we can't enter because we don't have enough equity to enter it. This one too has its entry is now sure. We can enter this one too. It has taken out this level around here too. It has taken out this level, so we can now take our entry. for this one as well. I think I want to for this one as well. Right, you can also see there is a moving down trend here. You can also see that the trend moving down at this point. So we expect it to come down at least to this level before the next spike happens. Right, so that is how you analyze it. Simple and easy. You don't need to be super before you can analyze the trade. See that it's just a channel, and you see that it is very, very effective. So we expect this thing to come down to this red line. Let me change the color to be white. So we should take the trade if our other ones take profits. Boom, we take profits. Now let's jump into this one. As our fourth entry for the day, guys. Our fourth entry for the day is this. The fourth entry, 51. This is boom 500. We are going to minus, rather. We're going to subtract 2 from the entry point. Subtract 2 from the entry point and you get your 2 candles. Right, we have entered our trade. Yeah, all right, we see that the boom has take profit. Okay, number 1000 as we enter. I told you guys it will sell from there. Look at that, we should be out by now if we enter the trade. All right, by now I should enter this trade though, but let me check beta trade. Let's take this one. Let's take crash. I'll tell you why we're entering this one, even though it's not meeting the stuff we are looking at. But I will show you why we are entering it. Okay. All right, I'm going to hold this trade. Why am I holding it? That's what I wanted to show you before the spike happened. Okay, now is the time to enter it normally, but I'll show you why I entered it at that point, even though I didn't notice these things happening. I saw something here called the divergence. Like I was saying earlier, this our indicator is showing uptrend direction. Why the chart is showing downtrend direction, that is divergence happening right there. So this trade, I'm not going to close it. I'm going to hold it to either take profit. I'm going to hold it to take profit. Let's watch it out. Okay. And the crash, I told you guys, I'm going to hold the trade. And crash has 2 profits. So that's 2 profit. Yes, that is the work of a divergence. Okay. I'm expecting it to, once it goes again, it goes above these levels here, I will enter again. Okay, because I know it will go up again, So if you learn to spot divergence in these indices, even if that is the only thing you have learned to do, then you are good to go. Look at why did I see the divergence? You could see that our window indicator is saying is a sell. Why the indicator window is actually going in the upward direction? That is this indicator is going upward like this. This one is going downward, and going upward. That is why the divergence. Okay, if you can learn only these things, only this one alone, then you are good to go. We are taking 5 trades today, so let us check if another trade. Oh, we missed this one already. Oh, let's not enter it because it's risky. This one too. You see that it spiked, but we missed the other entry. Let's check with 500. 500 too is still on this range. You see that it's still on that range. Okay, but we can't just enter because it's on a range. We want to be conscious. You see, this is my account. Anything it can blow. So let's not blow the account. All right, so. Let's see if I can see another better entry. I'll not take this one. Except if it crosses this level and this level, I will take it. If it crosses this small level here and this other small spike level here, I will enter it for 2 candles, my 2 pips candles and all that. Let's check 500. Maybe we'll enter this one if it goes again. Yeah, let's take this crash. It has crossed that level, so you might want to take that trade right now. Let's take the trade. My chat is not responding. I don't know why it's not responding right now. My chat is just not responding. I can't place. I'm pressing the entry point, but it's not working. Let me check my network. Chat is not responding. All right. See. Oh. I missed this one. There you go. Let's try and take it. Well, I missed the early entry. Crashing did not open. I don't know why. Until it's a spike happened, so I don't want to. Remember, this is our sixth entry. So our sixth entry. Just minus 2. If you are taking boom indices, just minus 2 from the entry point and you get the 2 candles equivalent. Okay? So, but our entry should have been early enough when these guys are took, when these guys from here is our entry. So by now we should take we should be out already, okay? But because I had issue with network, so that's why we're entering right now. So let's see if there are other ones that we can hope for to take once we are back, okay? You see this one, we should take our Tucanus before that spike happen. But all the same, we are going to see what happens. Yeah, let's take crash. So you guys, let's not take crash indices right now. It has crossed those two the spikes level here. Let's take our seventh entry. Remember, we are taking only eighth entry. This is our seventh entry for the day. So our target today is $3 only. It's 0.88.168. So we are taking just two more entries today, and we have made our target. Yeah, that is our target. Is this TP here, red line? Our target, our TP, our first TP. Okay, so you can see that we didn't use this one here. I just used this our analysis to know that to buy it. Okay, that's why I entered it. All right, let's check other trades to see if the ones we can enter after that one takes profit. All right, let's check other ones. 500. Wow, this is a good one to enter, but we don't have enough money to in this trade. This one, we should enter it as it crosses this level here. As it goes below this level, that's when we should enter our entry for our two candles trading style. Okay, even though we know it's going down, but because we are trading with high loss size, as we proceed, you see we're using high loss size. Okay, so we need to be really careful in the trade we are taking, because any pullback can blow the account. Okay, so we don't want to take any trade that will blow us easily. So let's check for other indices to see the ones that we take. I think we'll take this one. So this one too, if you have been here early enough, you can enter it once it has broken, it has go above this level here. You can enter your two candles, and by now it is already TP'd. So let's see if our entry. All right, we have a little spike here, but we're not going to be afraid of the spike. Yes, we don't need to be afraid of the spike. When you see things like this, all right, what you need to do is if you can hold this one to break even, because we know that normally the crash index right now is on a downtrend. If you check high time frame, it's on a total downtrend, even though the divergence there is just for a short time period. So because this is just high time frame, it's not showing any divergence here. Only on that time frame that we see the divergence, and is a short term buy, of which it has bought from right down here to the upside, which is actually a good one. Okay, so when you see things like this, we can hold to break even or exit, then find another entry. Okay, but for me, I'm going to hold it. If account blows, then let it be. I'll hold this trade. Let me see if it can take us something. Let me hold a bit. But if I should close this trade, then we'll have to take more two trades. It's one trade. I guess it's better to take more two than to lose this account. Let's see what happens to it. Yeah, guys, I told you I'm going to hold the trade, and now we have two profits. I'm now being tempted to enter another one. The same trade, even though it's actually not good enough, but I want to take it. I want to take it again from that same entry. I want to take it again from that same place. This is actually not what we should do. We should wait for a signal to come before you take this kind of trade. All right, I'm trying to just rush out this stuff so that we're trying to rush out this stuff so that we'll make our target. This is our entry for the day. This is our last entry for the day, guys. The last entry for today. Once we take profit, we are good to go. Once we take profit, we are good to go. Okay, see, crash 1000. Our entry should have entered the market here, but I saw it, but because I don't have equity to enter it, I didn't enter it. Okay, if entry was here, so we'll take it. If the crash take profits, we can enter it again, because I know it will still buy more on the upside. But I'm afraid there's a level here, except it goes off this level, I'm not gonna enter it, even though I know it's gonna. Okay, yeah, there's a level here. Sorry, this is my that is if Fibonacci I used to analyze something. Okay, so let's watch out, see, take other trades. Wow, this is now a buy. I wanted to show you guys this is called a flag. This is called a bullish flag, guys. All right, it's a called bullish flag. This is the pole. This is the pole of a flag, then this is the flags. Okay, so what do I expect? It should break out this level. We want to see it break out this our channel and go up. It should be going up. Even though it will sell, it will still sell, but it should go up to extent that it will go up to this level of red before it should sell. That is if it will sell. Okay, so I'm going to wait for it to break out that channel. But at least you see how it worked out. It came down to our TP, the red line, the white line, before the spike going up. That is the work of you knowing your channel and your trend lines. Okay, but at this moment, the buy is imminent. Buys is imminent. It should be buying right from here, maybe to come down to retest this level, then a buy will shoot up. Okay, let's check that stuff, see what's happening there. Well, boom, guys, we are done for today. We have took our profits and we have set for today. So, but then I want us to do something. I want to make this equity reach $10. Yes, I want to reach $10. So I will be needing to take more for trades today. All right, but that will not be here. I will do it at my leisure time because I'm not seeing a good entry right now to take. Okay, should we take this one? This one, it looks like we should take it. Okay, so guys, thanks for watching this video. And like, if you want to get the trading plan, comment, I want to get a trading plan, or do a video on that, then post on the comment section, like, share the video, and let's keep on going. All right, we want to make up to $1,000 within the next 2 weeks from today. All right, guys, see you guys in the next video. And please also, you can follow me on Facebook, my page, Humble FX Official. I will send a link on this video description. You can join our Telegram channel and Telegram group. All the links should be on the video description. So join them, and you're good to go. If you want to join our VIP, you are open. You can join us. You can see by today we are taking our trade today already. Our VIP, we are taking our trade for today. You see how we made our market today successfully on the VIP. So you can join us as a very cheap price. All right, guys, thank you so much for being here with me. See you guys in the next video.